Greetings everyone, today I am going to show you how to install Teacache and also two presets that I have found after doing a lot of tests about regular Wan 2.1 text-to-video and also image-to-video. I have done a lot of experimentation to find out the very best parameters to be able to use both image-to-video and also text-to-video model. It really took a lot of time to figure out the very best settings. After finding the best parameters, I made them as a preset and I am sharing them with you. So if you didn't follow our previous SwarmUI main tutorial and also Wan 2.1 tutorial, you should watch them first because I show how to install SwarmUI there with proper backend of ComfyUI and use our downloader. The links will be in the description of the video and the main post has been updated. It is now version 40, so click here to download it. Move the downloaded file into your SwarmUI installation folder, overwrite if it asks, then right click WinRAR extract here and overwrite all files to get them most up to date. First of all, I recommend you to update SwarmUI, so you see Windows update swarmui.bat file, more info run anyway. Now this update will update and also start the SwarmUI immediately and it has been started. Then go to the presets and import presets. Then choose file, go back to your installation folder and you see there is amazing SwarmUI presets. Double click it, overwrite existing presets to get the latest version. Don't worry, it will not overwrite or destroy your other presets. Import, and all four has been imported. Now you see there is 1.2.1 image to video and 1.2.1 text to video. We are going to use them, but before using them, enable display advanced options here. Go to the advanced sampling from here and you see there is install Teacache. So what Teacache does is that it will skip some of the steps during generation and it will speed up your generation significantly with minimal amount of quality loss. So it will ask you to install like this. Okay, you will see that it is installing Teacache like this. Wait for backends to be loaded. You can also follow the command line interface CMD window like this. If you get any error, just restart the SwarmUI entirely. Always you can use server logs debug to see more information. It has been installed, updated, and my backend is now working as expected. Okay, let's return back to generate tab. So now we have Teacache mode and everything is ready. Let's begin with image to video. So I have a prompt here. Click this hamburger menu and direct apply. So let's go through all of the configurations. This is the default configuration, but I will slightly change it for Teacache. So what is changing for Teacache? First of all, this is image to video, therefore I turn off this text to video. This is from my older config, not from this preset, because preset doesn't change the other stuff that you already set. So we go to the init image, choose init image file, let's use this one, and select your base model to automatically set your resolution. So if you are not going to generate in high resolution, select 1.2.1 14 billion parameters 480p model. You can download this with our SwarmUI downloader. How? Just double click Windows Start Download Models Updat file, more info run anyway. It will generate a virtual environment and start the downloader application. This is the latest interface of the application. You can see there are already tutorials that you can watch. And in the video generation models, 1.2.1 models, you will see all the models with one click to download. So image to video model is here. You can download FP16 version or like GGUF Q8 version. These are 720p. You can also download 480p. So it is all up to you. All you need to do is just click this to download. It will queue and download. If it is already downloaded, it will skip it. So we select our model. Then I click this res and use closest aspect ratio and it will set the resolution according to the model resolution. I had shown this in the previous tutorial. You can also set the model resolution from edit metadata and you see standard resolution is set here. Okay, what others we need? So there is image to video and select the same model. I think this is using this model. This is overriding the model selected here. So make sure to select both of them. So this configuration is what it is using. Video frames, it will use this. Video steps count, it will use this, not the steps count or the CFG scale set here. This is for image to video. So I will make this 30 steps because I find this is working the best with balanced for the Teacache. This video CFG is, I find it 6 is the best. It doesn't make too much difference with image to video and sigma shift is 10. So what else we need to set? We are going to set the T Teacache mode all, Teacache threshold 15%. And other than that, I am also using the frame interpolation with 2x, so it will be 32 FPS. So this is going to generate 49 divided by 16, 3 seconds with 32 FPS. Okay, let's click generate, debug, just wait, it will load the model and it will start generation. Make sure that you are updating your SwarmUI because there has been a bug which was fix it while I am recording the video because I have reported it. So you need to use latest version of the SwarmUI always. Okay, so it is loading the model. Yes, it started the generation. Now it is generating. You may not see steps are faster, but you will see that it will skip some of the steps. It will make some of the steps faster with Teacache. So you will get the final speed at the end of the video generation. Don't forget that. Okay, we can see that from step 5 to step 7 there is a jump, from step 3 to step 5 there is a jump. This is how Teacache works. So based on the Teacache algorithm, skip some of the steps that it calculates as those steps are unnecessary. We may lose a little bit of quality, but we shouldn't lose much. This is the working way of the Teacache, and it will speed up the generation significantly. Also, we are using Sage attention, which is the fastest attention for video generation. My ComfyUI installer is installing this without any issues for you, automatically for you into a virtual environment without breaking anything else in your computer, in your system. So the starting speed was 10.5 seconds per IT, and now it is 5.8 seconds per IT because the Teacache is working. Otherwise, all of the step speed would be same. Moreover, I am recording a video right now, so it is consuming a lot of GPU power. And about block swapping thing, I have learned that the ComfyUI automatically supports that. So in my last video, it wasn't working because of a bug. I still couldn't find exact reason of the bug, but in your case, it should work right away, normally. And you should see a power usage close to your power limit, like this case. And it has been generated, so we can see that the entire thing took like 3 minutes, and we should get the video in a moment. You can also change the video output type. You see from video format H265, and the video should have arrived. Let's see. Yes, the video has arrived, but for some reason it doesn't display here. So let's refresh. Let's click. Yes, still I can see. This is a recent bug that happens randomly. Let's download from here. Download. Let's open. And yes. Wow, really, really good. We can see that the animation, the quality, everything is really good. This is full screen view. Okay, since I am showing quick, they are not like longer generations. So let me also show you the text to video. For text to video, go to presets and text to video, direct apply. Then what are the changes? With text to video, we use the CFG scale set from here, and the number of steps are also set from here. So let's set it as 30 because I'm going to use Teacache. Text to video is selected. The text to video frame count, the FPS is set here. Text to video format you can set from here. We can also set the right frame interpolation from here. So the resolution will change according to the model. So let's select our text to video model. I'm going to use this model, text to video GGUF Q8. So this is the native resolution. You can also reduce resolution if you want to generate lower resolution videos, like make the 768. But let's go with this one to see. So there is no init image. Sampling is UniPC. There is no image to video. There is advanced video, and I'm using video FPS 16. And what else we can set? The sigma shift is 8. I find it best. But you can also change the sigma shift and CFG. It makes really a huge difference in text to video. And we are going to use Teacache 15%. So let's generate and let's see what will happen in the logs. Let's set this as debug. We are using GGUF Q8 version, which is almost same quality as FP16 version. You can also use FP16 version. With block swapping of ComfyUI with its optimization, it should work pretty fast. By the way, we are generating a high resolution video, so it is slower than previous generation. We are literally generating an HD video, 784 multiplied with 1136, so this is an HD video. But still, it should be fairly fast. Also, if you generate a longer video with more frame count, it will take longer. This is a 3 seconds video and it is getting faster as you are seeing with the T-cache. All right, so the video has been generated. It started with 27 seconds per IT and it get down to like 14 seconds per IT. It took like 8 minutes to generate. The video is here. For some reason, my browser is not displaying right now. So let's download and open. This is a probably temporary issue. And this is a full HD generation with Wan 2.1 model. You see like this. This is the quality of it. It's really, really high quality actually, but it didn't follow the prompt very well. Probably I need a better prompt to write, but the prompt is working better with image to video rather than text to video. So I will be doing more presets hopefully, and I will introduce them. It is best to learn how to use SwarmUI because it is leveraging the power of the ComfyUI. Therefore, it is really, really up to date and powerful. Thank you so much. Hopefully see you in future videos.